Myself, Satish Gowda, Assistant Professor and HOD, Department of Zoology, Government First Grade College of Arts, Science and Commerce, Sirar. Today, in this session, I am going to speak on topic Structure and Functions of Silk Plants for Tumkur University, 3rd BSc, 6th Semester Zoology, Paper 7, Applied Zoology. Structure and Functions of Silk Glands. So what are silk glands? Silk glands are modified labial glands which secretes silk. They are present in the silkworm. The silk glands lie ventral to the alimentary canal. In full-grown larvae, these silk glands occupy most of the body cavity. The silk glands are tubular in shape with different diameters in different regions. So the silk gland is paired structure divided into three distinct regions, namely anterior region, middle region and posterior region. Here you can see the structure of silk gland. You can observe here, this is the anterior region and this is the middle region and this is the posterior region. Anterior region has two straight tubes joining at the fore end and they open in the spinnert. Middle region is the largest and thickest of the three regions, and this region again is divided into three sub-regions and folded in W-shaped fashion and has three limbs, namely posterior limb, middle limb and anterior limb. The posterior limb secretes sericin and middle region acts as a reservoir. Here you can observe, this is the middle region of the silk gland which is folded in a W-shaped fashion, and these lobes are region of the gland again folded into three limbs, anterior, middle and posterior. And posterior region has a narrow coiled tube ending blindly. This part remaining coiled in middle portion to posterior portion of the body, above and sides of the gut. This posterior region, as I told earlier, this is a very blind coiled tube and which secretes fibroin. And along with this three regions of the silk glands, so there are a paired specialized glands are present. So they are Philippi's gland. A pair of these Philippi's glands situated at the junction of two tubes at the anterior region secreting viscous fluid of unknown function. See here, you can observe these are the specialized a pair of two Philippi's glands present at the anterior region of the silk gland. The secretes a viscous material which is unknown in function. And silk glands present in the larval stage of a silkworm produce a threads of silky material to form a cocoon. The silk gland is the only organ where silk proteins fibroin and sericin are synthesized and secreted in silkworm Bombyx mori. Silk proteins are stored in the lumen of the silk gland for around 8 days during the 5th instar larva, and these silk glands play a very important role in the in the spinning function, and these glands gives a silk threads and forms a cocoon around the fifth instar, and this fifth instar become the pupa inside the cocoon. And this is about the structure and functions of silk gland. So here you can see the structure of silk gland. So this is a paired in structure, and this paired structure of silk gland has three regions: anterior region, middle region, and posterior region. Anterior region is a thin and tube-like structure, a pair of tubes, straight tubes joined at the anterior end or fore end of at the anterior region, and these opens into the spinnert. So here spinnert helps to spin the silk. And this is the middle region. Middle region is wider and as the largest region, which folds as a W-shaped passion and which secretes sericin, and it acts as a reservoir. And each lobe again folded in three tubes, three limbs, so anterior, middle, and posterior limb. And the posterior region of the silk gland is blindly and highly coiled structure. And this highly coiled structure of posterior region of silk gland secretes fibroin. Fibroin and sericin, these two are very important to make silk thread during the spinning through the spinnert. And this is along with this, there are two specialized glands present at the either side of the anterior region of the silk gland. They are Philippi's gland. So these Philippi's gland secretes viscous material. And this is about the structure and functions of silk gland. Thank you very much. I'll meet you in the next session with a different topic.